tackling got away brilliantly, and he's ahead of the field at the moment, and Bolt going right in. Here comes Usain Bolt storming through. He takes it again, 9.64. He's retained his title in the most emphatic way.
So who's going to succumb to the adrenaline first? Van Niekerk is running blind on the outside and he's set off really quickly. The American, LeSean Merritt, closing the gap on Kerani James, and Van Niekerk still wide on the outside. And LeSean Merritt coming back at Kerani James, but it's Van Niekerk leading at the moment. It's an unbelievable victory by a huge margin, a century of history, and 43.03. Obliterated Michael Johnson's world record. The world champion is the Olympic champion. We've never seen anything like it in an Olympic final. Incredible. To win this, but Farhan's going to do it. The ultimate performance on the ultimate day from the ultimate warrior, 45.94. Yeah! He has just decimated his own world record. There is nothing this amazing Norwegian cannot do.
The men's 800 meters final. Here is the great man himself, David Rudisha, almost unbeatable. Will he make it fast? He's used to having pacemakers, he doesn't really need them. A great roar is the tall figure of Rudisha. It's fast, it's around 24.6 for the first 200 metres. This could be something very special indeed. It's quick, very quick, 49.28. That Olympic record looks set to go. None of them are good enough to hold on to Rudisha. But it's Rudisha coming into the home straight. We're going to be looking at the time very closely on this one. The three youngsters with Solomon finishing. But Rudisha, what's the time? It's a world record! A world record here in London at the Olympic Games from the greatest middle distance runner we've seen for a very long time. This is one of the greatest runs we've seen in Olympic history.
On your mark.
And Sherriott hasn't shaken off Ingebrigtsen. Timothy Sherriott, the world champion, striking out for glory. But look how cool and composed and calm Jakob Ingebrigtsen is. He has time to look behind him. 20 years of age, and he is on top of the world. Absolutely incredible from Jakob Ingebrigtsen.
Yes!
It's time for the final of the men's 5,000 metres. And they set off at a cracking pace. Kenenisa Bekele is the favourite going into this race. Into the final lap now. And it's Bekele in front. Kenny Sepekele keeping an eye on himself on the big screen. With more than 100 metres to go, he knows he won't be challenged. He's built up a significant lead, so the Olympic 10,000 metres champion is now also the 5,000 metres champion. Kenny Sepekele in a new Olympic record time of 12 minutes 57.82 seconds.
This man is the Olympic champion, Kenny Sepekele. He'll be one to watch for sure. Kenny Sepekele taking his time before making his move. Just past 8,000 meters with four laps to go. Mika Togo was in the lead, but away goes Bekele making his move. And with 200 meters to go, a quick check behind him. No one there. Kenny Sepekele, the Olympic champion from Athens and the favorite in this race, is the winner in a new Olympic record time. He is followed by his countryman, Celeste Shahini.
And it was the USA away quickest, with Trell Kimmins establishing a lead over Jamaica's Nesta Carter by the first change. Then on the final bend, Johan Blake blew Tyson Gay away to hand Usain Bolt a narrow lead over Ryan Bailey. The crowd and the clock told the rest of the story. Another new world record to Jamaica, taking 0.2 of a second off the old one.
LaShawn Merritt would be running the first leg for the USA, already a gold medalist here at these Olympics. They're in the blocks and they are off. Four laps around the track. After the first lap and into the first exchange, it is the USA in the lead and the Russian Federation, Jamaica, chasing them. After that second lap, into the second exchange, again watching to make sure the exchanges are clean, and they are away. David Neville runs a wonderful lap for the USA and stretches out the lead as Warner takes it around. He is chased by Christopher Brown of the Bahamas, and it finishes with a convincing win by the USA. Neville handing off to Jeremy Warner, and Warner, one of the fastest 400-meter men ever, running a strong anchor leg and comfortable victory for the USA.
The final of the men's 20-kilometer race walk. A 2-kilometer course, walkers go round 10 times. China had never won an Olympic medal in race walking, but that was to change here. Chen, in his first major championships, was to increase his lead. Chen turned his last circuit almost into a victory lap as he took the acclaim of the large crowds. What a birthday present for Chen, a gold medal. The men's race walk over 50 kilometres in the Mall, and a new Olympic record was about to be set. Also among the leaders, three Australians, including Jared Talent.
Beeman came to the Olympics in the form of his life and as the favourite for gold. With his first attempt in the long jump final, Beeman produced one of the finest individual athletic accomplishments of all time. Beeman knew it was good, but he didn't know how good. 8 metres and 90 centimetres, over half a metre further than the old world record.
Can he set another record here with the final throw? It's Crouser!
Yes.
It's massive! What a performance in the shot put here in Tokyo from Ryan Crouser. 23-3-0. It's not quite up to the world mark, but he smashed the Olympic record again.
Business, and it's about to get underway. So in Beijing's early morning, on a dry, clear day, they're off and running in the Olympic marathon. The roar of the crowd when he enters the main stadium lets him know that the ultimate prize is not far away. And once Liu takes the chance to enjoy his final lap around the bird's nest. Pace has been remarkable, and when he crosses the line, he's set a new Olympic.